Hey, what's good? It's your boy G Marcus Winters TV back with a brand new video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Of course, you can tell from the title, it's like I'm doing a quick reaction to J. Cole's new documentary that came out yesterday. Applying pressure the off season. I'm just getting you guys up. Of course, there's gonna be two videos coming, you know, this week for J. Cole. I'm dropping one tomorrow with How I Met J. Cole, and I'm also dropping the album review. So I'll be doing the album review the day it comes out. So be on the lookout for that. Definitely hit that notification button because those are coming. This is just a little quick thing I'm giving you guys. So, because the documentary comes out, I was happy as hell. Couldn't wait for something new for J. Cole. My problem with the documentary was it was too short. Too freaking short. Like, damn. Like, when I say short, it's short. I was not expecting it to be like that. I wasn't expecting it to be like a whole movie or nothing like that, but I was expecting, like, I don't know, like 50 minutes, an hour, like, what? But that was my only complaint about it. But I liked a couple of things about it, a couple of things I didn't know about J. Cole. Like, I remember in the song Power Trip that he had featuring Miguel, he had said, okay, back when I was sleeping in my mama crib, or even back when I was up there in Muhammad crib. And I bucked that song for years. That was even a ringtone. The Muhammad crib part, I really thought he was talking about his mama's crib. I had no idea he was talking about Muhammad. Like, comment down below if I'm the only one or if you caught that, like, comment down below, but I had no idea it was Muhammad he was talking about, not my mama. I was like, wow. But I'm really glad that, you know, they showed that, you know, Muhammad's crib or whatever. That's where he went to record. He chilled there, kicked it or whatever. So they showed that. Showed a lot of old footage, and that was cool. Now, his friends, like, I bangs with his friends. His friends was really cool. Like, he was getting high, getting drunk, going to the club, and falling asleep. So he said that, you know, I guess, I don't know if it's the same day or one day. His friends were just like, yo, do you really want to rap? Do you really want to become a rapper? Do you really want to do this shit? Or do you want to just do this, which is get high, drunk, and fall asleep? Like, what's really going on? So he said after, you know, they had that talk or whatever, he got his shit together. He started to, like, really, really go in the studio and rap. Now, that was crazy. I was like, really? We need more friends like that? Comment down below if you have friends like that and you want friends like that. We need more friends to say, hey, yo, you're he did not have a schedule. Like, that was actually interesting too. A lot of people have that. I've been there before. We all been there before where you don't have a schedule. Like, where we're just working to work. Like he said in the documentary, like how he was working so hard, the way it's like, if he wasn't doing 12 hours in the studio every day, there was a problem. Until Pharrell Williams came through and was just like, yo, like, you need a schedule, bro. Like, Pharrell literally does this from like 9 to 5. Like, that's what he does. Like, not the exact time, but he will do it at a set schedule. Like, after, when that time hits, he's gone. He looked at Pharrell crazy at one point, but then as, you know, as he got older or whatever, started growing, it was like, yeah, he was like, he realized that he has to really make it a schedule, make it a, like to the point where, like, when he had his kid or whatever, he put a studio inside of his house, so he was able to, like, work and still be around his kid. Like, it was like a punch in, punch out type of thing. So I find that to be pretty dope. I really feel like that will definitely inspire a lot of people out there that's working really hard. And shout out to all you hard workers out there. Like, your work is not unnoticed. Keep working hard. All my YouTubers, all my 9-to-5ers, like, everybody keep working. I had no idea that Middle Child was supposed to be on this coming album. I was like, what? Like, Middle Child, that was a hit. My girl, shout out to her, she was getting on my nerve when this song came out. She had a whole dance doing everything. We'd be in the kitchen cooking, and she's doing some dance. I was so annoyed because she would play it back to back. You didn't want it to get old. For all your artists out there, I'm pretty sure you could, like, relate to it. Like, sitting on music, sitting on videos, whatever it is, you don't want it to, like, get outdated, get too old. It's too hot that you just need to put it out. So yeah, you do not want to have them lost tapes. So all you artists out there, rappers, singers, like, YouTubers, don't make your stuff, like, just sit on dust. Put it out. It was a really decent documentary. It was really good. It wasn't nothing crazy, nothing too special. I expected more from it, but it was good. Like, it was watchable. Like, yeah, I can't really give it too much of a rating, but yeah, it was good. It was definitely decent. Definitely should watch, all you diehard fans on that, and even people that's trying to get inspired. So, you guys made it to the end of the video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Do not forget to subscribe. Do not forget to hit that like button, especially if you like the video. You want to see more of your boy. I have two videos coming this week. I have Meeting J. Cole, when I met J. Cole for the first time ever. Also, I have coming the album review, so that's coming. Definitely going to do a review on the album. So, stay tuned. Your boy will be dropping you consistent videos every single week. You guys have a good one. It's your boy G Marcus with the TV signing off.